VLOOKUP may be good, but misuse of VLOOKUP is bad. So this video shows you one common scenario where VLOOKUP should not be used, and then I'll give you the solution. In fact, I'll give you two solutions. So let's get started. This is the base data, transactional data. First column is product ID, and then some other details about the sale. I need the product names and other details, so I have a product master. Both are tables. This table is called products. Now I need to calculate the total cost, which is quantity multiplied by unit price. And in order to do that, I have to use VLOOKUP. So I'm going to add a VLOOKUP, pick up the product name, pick up the third column, get the unit price, and then I'm going to multiply quantity by unit price. Of course, anyway, I got some other columns also from there for descriptive reasons. And then I also want to calculate the total weight. For that, another VLOOKUP, I got the unit weight. And that's how, in real life, you will see that there is one master table and multiple columns from that master table are being fetched by using multiple VLOOKUPs. Only thing which is changing is the column index number. This is an overhead. The problem is, it's going to increase the file size, make it slow, and then it will force you to pay specialized values. But when more data comes, you have to repeat the process. So it is inefficient. There are two approaches to solve this problem. Which approach you use depends on the situation. Do I really want all these raw data columns with calculations in Excel? Am I going to add some further functions on it? Then this VLOOKUP can be eliminated by using merge functionality in Power Query. On the other hand, if you want to analyze this data, summarize it, aggregate it, visualize it, then you don't need to see the data in Excel sheet. You have to use the data model solution. So two solutions, Power Query merge and data model. So let's start with the Power Query solution. In order to simplify things further, I have kept the data in two separate files. The transaction file is here, table name is TXN. The product master is a separate file. It has a table, table name is products. Now what do we do next? We start a blank new file and close the original files. We will import both of these tables in Power Query. So I go to data, get data from file, pick up the transaction file. In the navigator, choose the table, never the sheet. And I'm going to say load to only create connection. I could have done it later also, but I prefer to do this because later on you get confused, choose the wrong option. Might as well start with this. Now it opens Power Query, shows me the data. I want to get another table. New source is right here. File, Excel workbook. I'll pick up the products table. This time we don't see transform button because we are already inside Power Query. That means we are already in transform mode. So click OK. We'll see two tables on this side. Now what I really want to do is some columns from products. I want to match the product ID and put it along with TXN so that I can do those calculations and whatever else I want to do with it. The operation for that in Excel is the VLOOKUP version. Here, that thing is called merge queries. Now, merge queries has two things here. Always open a drop down when you see one. This one will merge into the currently selected table. So in this case, whatever I do in merge, the columns from product will physically be added to the TXN table. The other one is merge as new. What does that mean? That means merging will happen, but the merged table will be separate. I always prefer this option because it doesn't mess around with existing data. In any case, what Power Query is doing is never going to touch the raw data. We are talking within the context of Power Query. Also, it makes sense to keep individual tables separate. I'm going to say merge queries as new. Notice that TXN table is selected. It's basically asking you, this table is TXN. Do you want to merge it with another table? Yes. So choose it. And now the important thing, how are we eliminating VLOOKUP? We select both the columns and it actually matched all of them already before I clicked. If there was a mismatch, either because of a missing value, data type mismatch, spelling, whatever, it would have actually told me there is a problem before even I executed the process. This is one benefit of using merge instead of VLOOKUP. The other benefit is sometimes one column is not matched. Multiple columns are matched. What do you do in VLOOKUP? Create another column, concatenate, and then do it. You have to do it on both sides. Here, you just select multiple columns, and that's it. Now, of course, in this case, we don't need to. So I'm going to unselect it. Just PID here, product ID here. We are good to go. Click OK. Merge one. A new table got created. I'm going to call it fine. Where is that merge thing? It will be at the end. But instead of adding the actual columns from the products table, it has given a table for each row. So let's look at this one, W439. So third row has a table. If I go inside the table, this one is the equivalent row from product table. So we do have product ID and all other columns, but right now we are not seeing them as individual columns. We are seeing them as a table. How do we get rid of the table and let the table expand into individual columns? This is the miraculous button, the expand button. Now it's asking me, which columns do you want to expand? Ideally, I want all of them, or maybe you want some of them. Choose the correct ones. But one thing you must do, that is, product ID is the matching column. That's already there in the base table. You don't need to repeat it. So whatever is the matching column or columns, remember to unselect. Another thing you have to unselect is this, original column name as prefix. If you don't uncheck it, the columns will come in, but each column will have a name like products.unitprice, products.warranty. That's bad. So remove this checkbox and then click OK. And now we got a merge table without doing a single VLOOKUP. Before I import the data, might as well do the calculated columns right here in Power Query. Remember, we wanted total cost and total weight. So go to column, add column, custom column, and give it a name. Just put the formula, quantity multiplied by unit price. Always check syntax, or the new column will be added at the end. Let's repeat this process and also get total weight. Both these columns got added at the end. Another benefit of Power Query, you must know, I can move these columns anywhere. Much easier to move them than in Excel. But if, for example, you want to take them to the beginning, don't drag. Right click, say move, and say move to beginning. Another thing with calculated columns, it doesn't do the data type checking automatically. So it's ABC 1 to 3. What does that mean? Any data type. That means it has not detected the data type yet. No problem. We'll select both the columns, go to transform, detect data type, make sure it is correct, whole number and decimal. Fine. Now we are good to go and I want to import the data. So I'm going to go to home, close, close and load to. Always create connection. And then explicitly go to the one you really want and then load to table. Now that we have got the table in Excel, you can, so that's number one solution. The number two solution comes into picture. If you wanted to do exactly all this, but the only objective was to analyze, create reports, pivot tables, charts. Yes, you could have done this right here. In load to, I could have directly set pivot table instead of Excel. Very good. Now, because it's going to delete that table from the sheet, it gave you a warning. But now you got a direct pivot table and everything is working fine. But when data grows, this is going to make it very slow. So the second option is if you only want to analyze things, use data model. So let's see how to do that. Again, I'm going to create a blank new file and we are going to get data from both the tables in Power Query. We have already done that, so I'm going to skip those steps and start after we have both the tables in Power Query. Earlier, we used the merge operation. And do you know what was the disadvantage of merge operation? The description, the unit price, the warranty, everything got added as a column in the transactional table. So the same description repeated for the same product. So that repetition is going to increase data size and reduce performance. So the correct way of using this for analytics is not to do the repetition at all. We will import these tables in data model instead of Excel sheet. How do we do that? Well, go to close and load or load to. create only connection and add this to data model. Right now I'm doing it for TXN and now nothing seems to have happened, but the data has gone into data model. Where is data model? Power Pivot, this green button, manage data model window. The same button also exists in data. Ideally, this should be added to quick access toolbar, very, very useful. But well, it's going to show me two tabs and a grid-like thing. It looks like Excel. It is not Excel. This is data model, Power Pivot. They also look like Excel sheets, but they are not Excel because you can't change anything here. You can add calculated column, but the actual data you cannot change. If you want to change the data, go to the original file, change it, and then refresh. We have to go to diagram view and create a relationship. Diagram view shows just the column names. I know that this PID, same as product ID, just drag drop. From any direction, you can drag drop. For this to work, products ID should be unique in the products table. So it's saying on this side, there'll be one product. Here, you can sell the products many times, one too many. Now the job of this guy is done. Create a regular pivot table. This time the pivot table is from data model. And now I get what? Both the tables. So if I want name of the product, I'm going to pick up from product table. If I want quantity, I'm going to pick it up from transaction table. I want quantity multiplied by unit price. Like we did earlier in Excel, we have to add a calculated column. We'll go to the data model and add the calculated column. So let's go to the data view in Power Pivot. I'm going to add a column, total cost, like we did earlier. Now it seems to add an empty column and it's asking me what is the formula. Quantity, I can pick up square bracket. I'm in the table, so I don't have to give table name, just square bracket and the name of the column. So if I type products, yes, it's showing me products table. But when I do square bracket, it's not showing me the column names. And generally when that happens, that means you are making a mistake. Of course, this is not going to work. Products table is related to this table. So actually use a function called related. The syntax of this is related column name. So now I'm just going to choose products unit price. And this will work. Now using the same method, I'm going to calculate the total weight. And that's it. Now in earlier scenario, you noticed that I would have added more columns, one for description, one for warranty. Basically other columns in transactions I need. And that's another benefit of this approach. I don't need those at all. So let's go back to our pivot table and see what happens. This is the product name. Along with the product name, I want description. Now, if you go to the data model, in the transaction table, we have not got description column at all. It's going to come from here. And that's absolutely okay. It understands what to do. I'm going to make it tabular mode so it looks easier to understand and get rid of the subtotals. So even though I'm referring to multiple things in the pivot table from both the tables, without any duplication, I can get the same job done. So that's how data model gives you many benefits. The other benefit, which is not obvious in this demo, is now that the data is in data model, there is no upper limit on number of rows. I can have multi-million rows imported here. The file size will be small. I will still be able to create relationships, create calculated columns, measures, and have extremely fast pivot table. So bottom line, stop misusing repetitive VLOOKUP when there are two different approaches, either merge queries or data model. So that's it for now. Thank you.